Hi guys, I've set everything up here in this kitchen because in this video we are going to make some tea. Is that the video all about, making some tea? No, we are going to make some tea and then use the tea to make some kombucha. Then the scoby from the kombucha will be used to make something interesting later. By the way, if you are here for the first time, I'm Josh and this is my DIY channel, Video Epo. This is not a regular DIY channel or I do not upload regular videos. So it's best for you guys to subscribe to my channel and click on the notifications icon so that you will be notified whenever I upload new videos. With that said, let's dive into the video. This, my friends, is a pack of scoby that I ordered from Amazon,
which happens to be the main element of this project, and as always you will find the links for the purchase in the description below.
Apart from the scoby, and by the way, scoby stands for symbiotic culture of bacteria and yeast. Apart from this particular scoby, we also need some black tea and some white sugar. And the reason why I'm saying white sugar, because sometimes sugar is also brown in color. I cannot say brown sugar, but the sugar itself is brown in color, and in South India we call it as Nati Chakrai. And for the choice of the vessels, I've got this container which is made of glass, and this is usually used to store cookies and sell it in the shops. And I got this container from a wholesale market. The height is roughly about 18 inches and the diameter is roughly about 10 inches or something. Which is not so important if you're not really worried about the shape of the scoby that you want, because you can see from the pack that I've received, it's round in shape. It means, or you can take a wild guess, that it was fermented in a container with the diameter of this particular size. To store this for later use, I've got another glass jar which has got a lid on top. So this will be used to store the scoby for later use. And you also might need something to cover the entire solution, the brew, whatever you're going to make. And for that, I'm going to use some cloth. And I'm going to give it a nice wash. And I'm going to boil it in hot water so that it is free of all of any kind of contamination.
Having a pair of gloves is a must to avoid any contamination. Water is being boiled in two separate containers, one for the tea and the other one for sterilizing all the materials used in this process. While the water was set to boil, I took the filter cloth and I cut it to desired size. It's better to be generous here than regret later. I cut two pieces, one to filter the tea leaves and the other to cover it later. Now I think this should do. Once the water came to boil, these filter cloth were dipped into it. This way the impurities can be washed off and the germs can be killed. Then a cup of tea leaves were emptied into a glass. This is just for a rough measure. Tea leaves are then added to the boiling water. Again, nothing fancy here. We are just making some black tea, that is without any milk or any other additives. While the tea is getting ready, I poured hot water in the jar and cleaned them as well. Simply slushing the water on the walls of the jar for a couple of minutes should be fine, I guess. Since the glass jar is already soaked in hot water, I thought it would be fine to pour the hot black tea in it. By placing the filter cloth on top, the tea was then drained into the jar. I rolled up the filter cloth and I gave it a tight squeeze to drain every drop of the tea into the jar. We are now left with tea leaves which can be added to plants when cooled down. At this point, we have almost one third of the jar filled with black tea, and while it's hot, it's better to add the sugar. It would dissolve faster. For one cup of tea, I'm using 6 cups of sugar. I'm really not worried about how this is going to taste later because I'm after a thick layer of scoby. You can see that the sugar is settled in the bottom and I have to stir it for quite some time, till it's dissolved completely and the whole solution needs to be cooled down to room temperature. After cooling the black tea, it was time to introduce the starter scoby in it. Note that if the tea is too hot, it is gonna kill the scoby. Be gentle on it. A small piece was cut and preserved in the smaller jar, while the big chunk went into the main jar. I closed the lid of the small jar and I kept it for later use, but I closed the bigger jar with a cloth. This is going to be aerobic fermentation, that is, it needs air. I used the rest of the cloth to tie it around the jar. Here you can see the scoby floating gently on top. This jar would be kept in a dark place with good ventilation.
It's exactly a month now and it's time to pull kombucha from its hiding, which happens to be a dark place with a lot of ventilation.
Now here is a very quick alert for you guys. If you have phobia for something that is slimy, something that is grimy, I would request you to pause this video right here and forward this video to a couple of minutes. If you're still watching this, let me tell you that I don't find this disgusting because most food preparations have something similar. If you think about it, I took extra care to keep the entire process sterile to avoid any contamination, and I guess I've got it right. Let us take a closer look as to what has happened. The SCOBY, which stands for the symbiotic culture of bacteria and yeast, has multiplied vastly and it's floating on top of the kombucha.
After a month, it has formed a layer on top, and this layer should be around 10 mm or something.
It looks slimy and grimy, but it makes up for it by its strong aroma, which is really pleasant.
It smells really good, yeah.
This is like killing two birds with one stone. We get the kombucha as well as we get the SCOBY. I've seen a lot of videos in which they claim that SCOBY's got a neutral taste and it's being used to cook. And we also get kombucha, which comes with arguably a lot of medical benefits.
So it's time to open this up and have a look at the content inside. There we go.
So the first thing I need to do is get the SCOBY out of this container, for which I'm going to need some gloves because I want to keep the solution as sterile as possible.
I've got a stack of papers here so that it can catch all those liquid that is oozing out of this. And this glass here is being heat treated so that it is not going to contaminate if I'm going to scoop a little bit of kombucha out of that big jar.
After I put my gloves on, I reached out and I picked up the SCOBY. It is not as slippery as I thought it would be, or maybe the gloves has its grip. To my surprise, the original piece of SCOBY which we put in there was just the way it was, and I was hoping that the new growth would engulf it, but it has not. Let me show you the close-up of how it looks like. So here is how it looks like fresh out of the brew, and I think we have a workable material for our next stage. What is the point of brewing kombucha and not tasting it? So I've taken just a little bit. I've never tasted this before in my entire life. In fact, this is the first time I'm doing it. So let me just taste it. It's got that a little bit of tang and sour taste to it. It still has retained that flavor of tea. And I think I'm gonna add some more sugar and some more water and dilute it a bit because I think it's too acidic. I was anyways going to alter the taste of kombucha once I get a thick layer of SCOBY. Maybe this is dark because I used a high concentration of tea, which I personally think was good because the color has turned out to be dark brown. Once dry, it might look like a real piece of leather.
This is a SCOBY that we had made, and this is the original SCOBY that we put in that solution. And if you touch it with your bare hands, it feels like if I'm touching some raw meat or yeah, something like that. It gives that kind of a feel. And I'm gonna dry it. And not a big thing here in Chennai, for the climate is really too hot and humid. And the pepper is also going to absorb the excess moisture and water from that. So let it dry for a couple of days, or as long as it takes, and I will meet you after that.
To make sure it dries faster and the surface evens out, I placed a few newspapers and added a weight on top. This should definitely speed up the process. If you had skipped the video and come here directly, here is a very quick recap, but without the visuals. What I did is I took the SCOBY out of the kombucha and I placed it on a pile of newspapers so that the newspapers could absorb all those excess fluid. Then after some time, I added some more newspapers and then added another huge weight on top so that it could squeeze the SCOBY. And this is what I've got. The thickness is reduced almost to 2 mm, and this looks like an overburnt chapati. What I did is I placed this in the hot Chennai summer sun and it did its job. The next thing I'm going to do is give this piece a bit of a oil treatment because this dried SCOBY is not waterproof at all. The moment it is going to come into contact with water, it is going to swell up and be of no purpose whatsoever. Therefore, I'm going to give it a bit of an oil treatment. Also, it is going to avoid the moisture from the atmosphere ruining it. So before giving the oil treatment, I have to draw a circle on top because you know, once the oil treatment is done, drawing anything on it is going to become difficult. So let's draw the circle first.
I used regular cooking oil and covered both the surfaces in the oil using a sponge. Then I meticulously cut around the circumference with scissors. I did not waste the pieces that I cut. Instead, I braided them into a small rope, which you can see here. If I try to pull it, I find that it is incredibly strong. I've got some zippers from my previous projects, and the pouch I'm going to make is going to be rather simple. I'm going to fold it in half and attach a zipper to it. Now I have to do some stitching. There is something worth mentioning here. If I hold it against the light, you can see the thickness of this material is not consistent. I really do not know why. So here is a small pouch I made from the homegrown leather-like material, which happens to be dried up SCOBY really. The pouch itself is not very impressive, I know, but this, my friends, is a proof of concept. The fact that it is made by fermenting regular black tea is something really amazing, and scientists are working hard on how to make this water resistant, and a lot of research has been going on this particular concept. For me, it was a cool DIY project and a science experiment, which I really liked. I made a small leather pouch and a whole jar of kombucha. I hope you like this video, and if you do, please share it with your friends and subscribe to my channel Video Epo. As always, thanks for watching. I'll be back with another interesting and entertaining video.